Friends, we'll continue with the 11th standard economics. Our next chapter is that Indian economy. Seventh chapter is that Indian economy. A country's economic growth usually measured by the national income. That is the GDP. That is GDP in the sense gross domestic product. Gross domestic product can be evaluated by the goods and services produced by the country within a year. Within a year, how much the goods and services produce, on basis of that only the GDP is calculated. So not only the GDP, using GDP one cannot be considered to be a country can be a developed or underdeveloped. Including GDP, the life quality of a life of a citizens also can be considered to be as a country can be developed or not. So in that HDI, Human Development Index, and also the PQLI, physical quality of life. So this both includes a birth rate, death rate, life expectancy of a people. The people can be living happily, healthily, a medical facility is there in a country or not. So including this, we have a GNHI, that is a National Happiness Index. So it includes the sustainable development, environmental conservation, and also the promotion of a culture, and also the political stability, smooth stability should be there in a country. So including GDP, this quality of a life, all these three should be included. So on base of that only, some of the countries can be considered to be a developed countries. That is UK, Japan, USA, or France are considered to be a developed country. And some of the underdeveloped countries are Africa, Myanmar, Pakistan, Bangladesh can be considered as an underdeveloped country. So on base of this only, India can be considered the seventh largest country in the world. So there are some futures for the developed countries. First one, there should be high quality of a standard of living should be there, high national income should be there, high per capita income should be there, there should be a full utilization of resources should be there, full employment should be there, the technology, high technology should be there, and also urbanization of should be improved in the country, and also equal distribution of political, economical, and also the gender equality should be there. On base of that only, a country can be considered to be the developed country or underdeveloped country.
A Indian economy is considered to be a seventh largest economy of the world. Here you can see the diagram. It has a 7% growth rate, average growth rate every year. It has some futures of a goodness or strength of the Indian economy. We can go and see. First one is India has a mixed economy. That means both private and the public sector join together in the progress growth of an Indian economy. So this is a clear indicator, perfect model for the public and private partnership. Next is agriculture plays the key role. Here, agriculture is the backbone of the Indian economy. Over 60% of people depend upon the agriculture. 17% of a GDP contributed from the agriculture sectors only. After the Green Revolution, an Indian farmer started producing food grains of self-sufficient food grains. That means whatever Indian citizen needed for the food product, we only started producing after the Green Revolution. It is a very important in the field of agriculture sectors. So after the Green Revolution, we started producing the surplus production. Then we started exporting that to the other countries, like fruit, vegetables, spices, vegetable oil, tobacco, animal skin. So all this started producing. We started earning the forex, that means foreign exchange. So our economic growth rapidly increasing in international trading. Next, we'll go for the emerging markets. Here, India has a stable growth of GDP. This was attracted by the foreign capital, foreign investors. FDI means foreign direct investment. FII means foreign institutional investors. Seeing all this stable growth of India, the other foreign industries, they wanted to launch their industry, and also they wanted to open their branches in India. So this helped our Indian economy to grow in the world market. Next is a emerging economy. India has a 7th place in the GDP, in the worldwide. And also it has a 3rd in the PPP, that is Purchasing Power Parity. So because of this, because we have achieved a stable GDP level, so our Indian citizen is able to purchase a product. Our standard of living is increasing. So this is attracted by other countries to launch their industry in India. So we have a 3rd place in PP, Purchasing Power Parity. So this made our India to be a powerful place in the G20 countries. These are the G20 countries: Argentina, Australia, Brazil, Canada, China. So these are the G20 countries. In these countries, India has a powerful place in decision making. Next is a fast growing service sectors. So India has the fast growing sectors, the IT and the BPO, that is business process outsourcing. IT means information technology. In this field, India has a skilled labor, because India is more in the youth population. So it has a skilled labor, skilled employees. This is attracted by the other foreign countries. So they wanted to open their branches in India, multinational companies in India. So this also helped us to grow our economy level in the international level. Next is we are increasing in the field of industry of iron and steel industry also, and the heavy industry also. Next, fast growing service sectors. That is IT company, BPO, as I said before. In the fast growing sectors, actually in the 2016 and 17 survey, we are increasing stable growth in the GDP level in 7.1% next to China. Next, we'll go further. A rapid growth in urban areas. The people wanted to settle in the urban area because of all the facilities. The standard of living is increasing. So the improvement in the modernization of urbanization is become a must in the field of transport, communication, education, health. So we have started increasing our urbanization growth after the independence. Next, we'll go for the stable macro economy. So here in the stable macro economy, according to the economics, this survey year of 2014 and the 15, 8%, that means 8.5, 8.2, we are targeting to a growth in the field of GDP. That is a prediction by the economist. But we achieved only the 7.6, less than 7.6%. But it is a clear indicator that we are growing. Our stable macroeconomics started growing. Next is a demographic dividend. Demographic dividend in the sense, India is, as I said before, India has a youth population, more populated. So in that youth population, too much. So this is a motivation for the skilled labor, skilled trained employees. This is also one of the reason it's attracted by the foreign countries to launch their countries in India. Next, we'll go for the weakness of Indian economy. Large population. India is said to be the second largest populated country in the world. Here you can see our Indian population yearly increasing. It is equal to the total population of Australia. Australia's full total population is equal to 1 year population of India. So we think that how much we are populating. So India is considered in the last over 100 years, India is considered to be a quintupled its population size. That is, 4 madang increase irukum. So this is one of the main weakness of Indian economy. Next is inequality and poverty. In India, income and asset owned by top only 10% people are having. There are many people, many more people are living below poverty line, BPL line. So here inequality distribution of income, national income. Here rich become richer, poor is poorer only. Next, we'll go for the increasing price of essential goods. Here, the price of essential goods has started increasing, steady increasing, we can say. But the salary of an individual is not increasing as much as the price of a product increasing. So, this will adversely affect the poor people whose income is not protected. Next, we will go for the weak infrastructure. Weak infrastructure means when compared to the foreign countries, when compared to the developed country, our Indian infrastructure is still in backwards in the field of power project, transport facilities, storage facilities also. Because of the green revolution, our Indian farmers producing more production they are doing in the field of agriculture. But there is no storage for godowns. It's not there to store the goods, store their grains. So still we are in the backwardness in the field of storage, transport, communication also. Next, we'll go for the inadequate employment generation. As our Indian economy, youth population is more when compared to other countries. Here, there is a more people, there are more people with the unemployed. There is no creation of new jobs for the people. As much population increase, keep on increasing, equal to that a job opportunity should be created. But here it's not there. So many of the people are unemployed. So Indian economy is said to be as a jobless growth economy. Next, I will go for the outdated technology. Indian agriculture in the field of technology and also in the agriculture also, in the small scale industry also, we are using outdated technology. That means obsolete technology, paramayana, traditional one we are using. We cannot be competitive with the developed countries when compared to the USA, Canada and all. Because of all this, we are still in the backwardness in the field of technology and also in the field of agriculture also. So these are all the futures and weakness of Indian economy.